Hello students, how are you all? I am Arindam Minath sir. Today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter 4, metals and non-metals. Regarding this chapter, as per your interest, you want to know that it is coming under physics, chemistry or biology. We can say that this chapter, metals and non-metals, is a typical chapter of chemistry, but a part of physics is also involved. In some other cases, it is also called as physical science. So you can say it's a part of chemistry and physics both. So metals and non-metals is two words. I think, dear students, you are very much familiar with this term metals and its uses also. Every day in our life we come across of many uses where we have to use metals, like utensils, like electrical wires. So many things we are using metals. Instruments made up of metals like axe we are using, are made up of iron, that is a metal. And non-metals also. Suppose the cushion where you are sleeping, that is a non-metal. The chair of wood, PVC, plastic, are non-metals. So both of these are of our daily use. So in generally we classify the materials within these two groups, metals and non-metals, whatever you can see written on the board. But how we can compare a metal with non-metal, it is our first introduction to understand. By holding a material, how we can judge by holding a metal or a non-metal. So let us come to that point. So here I have collected one very familiar and homely article. You can see I am holding a ball. Yes, I think you are laughing, but it is our very common example. You need not to go outside to search example. You can also take one ball or any other steel plate in your hand for better understanding. This metal, you can see, I am striking this metal with a stick. Can you hear the vibration? More. Now I am striking a non-metal, also an example with me, that is a plastic body. Found the difference? Again I am showing the same experiment. So this is giving a vibration of ringing sound, but non-metal, you cannot get any vibration of ringing sound. So our first observation is that metals can produce a ringing sound, and there is a scientific term for that. We say metals are sonorous. Sonorous means ringing sound. They can produce a ringing sound, but non-metals are non-sonorous. That is, they cannot produce any ringing sound. So this is one of the common property. Coming to the next one, the metals, you can see, are shining. Can you see the shine? It is shining, it is glistening, but the non-metal doesn't. So I am holding parallelly, you can see the shine in this metal, but here there is no shine. That means it is blinking, shining, when light is falling on it, but it is not blinking. That property, that metals have a shining character, it is called lustrous. That means metals are lustrous, whereas non-metals are non Lascaris. These are two very common identifying properties of the metals and non-metals. So these are called common properties. By observing, we can understand. Now, what are experimental properties? We cannot see it, but we can understand by experimenting on them. One property I am writing, you will understand. Because metals can conduct electricity. Also, we can conduct heat. So metals can conduct electricity and heat. This we cannot understand by touching the metal. We need to experiment it. So some experimental views we will get in some other videos, but here we are going only through the properties to understand the introductory differences between the metals and non-metals. So here only you know this fact that metals can conduct electricity and heat also. This you can understand by seeing the examples in your home, because the electrical wires are made up of aluminium, copper. So these are metals. The utensils are made up of metals. Just I have shown you one utensil. These are made up of metals. So utensils are used to heat while we cooking the food. So these can conduct heat also. So metals can conduct electricity and heat. So metals are called conductors, whereas non-metals are non-conductors. That means they cannot pass through the heat or electric current. But there are some exceptions. If I give the example of a pencil lead, you are writing with pencils, the pencil lead, that is a graphite, it can conduct electric current, but not the heat. So some examples are there which are exceptional, that you will know afterwards. But the general property is that the metals are conductors and non-metals are non-conductors. One more experimental property. Metals are malleable and ductile. Metals are malleable and ductile. That means metals can be melted into thin sheets, and it can be also melted to draw out thin wires. I give you an example. I think you have seen the goldsmiths when they are making the gold ornaments. Suppose they want to make one thin necklace, that is wire in the neck. So this thin necklace, when they make, they melt the gold biscuits, they draw it into thin wire. Also the electrical wires of copper, aluminium, they are also melted to draw out the thin wires. Like this, when the metals are used to make some articles which are thin sheets, suppose some blades you are using as razors, those blades are thin sheets of metals. So they can be melted and they can be converted into thin sheets. So converting into thin sheets is the property called malleable, and converting it into thin wires is called ductile. So metals are malleable and ductile. Obviously we have to apply heat for them according to the type of the metals. The degree or temperature of the heat varies. So it is also a experimental property. In that case, we can say that the Non-metals are neither malleable nor they are ductile. So you can say they are non-malleable and non-ductile. So today, dear students, we are closing this comparison between these five physical properties. So these five physical properties are the basic properties to understand about the metals and non-metals. Other properties are also there. We discuss it in our next classes. Till then, be happy. See you next time.